We're driving to Weston in South Florida from our house, which is, well, not our house, but from the school. So it's like a 5-hour drive, and we're on I-4 right now, I-4. And we have directions, and we're going down there to see a doctor, a GI doctor, and a surgeon at the Cleveland Clinic for getting pacemaker for my stomach, so it'll shock my stomach, get my muscles moving for my gastroparesis. My mom's in the car with us. I don't know if you can see
my dollar store sunglasses.
Yeah, we bought dollar store sunglasses because it's really bright out, but we don't have scissors, so we have a little tag thing sticking out. So, yeah. So we're in the car, and we've only been in the car for like an hour, and we're already bored. So, yeah, we have a rental car, and it's a Chevy Cobalt.
Bright red.
It's bright, bright red. Let's see it out the window. Maybe you can see it out the window of the car. And so we're on the interstate. And we are just waiting to go down there. My appointment is tomorrow. I have 2 appointments. And hopefully they'll be able to set up a date for the appointment for the surgery. And hopefully we like the doctor and the surgeon, and they explain everything well. And I'm not really sure what's going to happen, but I just hope it's going to be good. And that it can start making my life back to normal, because that would be great. And yeah.
And what are we waiting your call for?
Oh. We are in the car and we are waiting for a call. Okay, here's what happened. Last night, yesterday, we were watching Mystery Diagnosis on the Discovery Heart Health channel. Hey, there's dinosaurs. And we're there really is. See? Look. Dinosaurs! Okay. We're watching, we were watching Mystery Diagnosis on Discovery Health channel, and this is not going to be good. We're watching Mystery Diagnosis on the Discovery Health channel, and we're watching all the different things, and we've been watching them in the past, the different episodes, for, see like what other people have who have rare diseases and stuff and what they had to go through and like how hard it is for them to get diagnosed and everything. So we were watching that, and then we went on the computer and I was researching to see if they had anything on their website about gastroparesis or if they've ever done like an episode on gastroparesis or anything, and they have not. So we found the email of the guy for, they're actually doing casting right now for a season, and we sent them an email last night, and they emailed us today, emailed my mom and said, is there any way that you can talk today on the phone and we want to interview you guys, and you have to fill out a questionnaire and like you have to have people who can be interviewed for the show and stuff. So that's kind of exciting. Not because we're going to be on TV, but because we're going to spread awareness of gastroparesis, and hopefully somebody will be watching it is like having the symptoms of gastroparesis, and they'll be able to get diagnosed faster so they can have better luck with treatment and not have to be on medicines that they don't need to be on. And it'll help them be able to live better, and it'll be easier on them if they have a name for their diagnosis, for their disease that they have. So that's the main reason why I want to do it, is just to bring awareness, because I think gastroparesis really needs to be made aware, and I don't think it's right that people are having to sign petitions just to keep funding for motility research and stuff. So yeah, and we are waiting. The guy said he would call today, so we told him after 1 o'clock would be fine. It's now 2:03, so he might call today and he might not call today. I don't know, but he seemed interested, so that's cool. That's all for now. We'll probably do another video log later. probably get bored again. Okay. Bye.
Bye.